In this tutorial, we're looking at the Blackmagic Proxy Generator. Proxies are incredibly useful in a variety of scenarios. Here are a few. Number one, when disk access speed is a bit too slow, for example, to handle high resolution, high bit depth files. Number two, when you're working with computationally intensive files that your CPU or GPU struggle to decode in real time, such as a highly compressed file or a raw file. And number three, when using collaborative remote workflows where sending the original camera media is not practical or necessary. Of course, it's possible to create proxies within DaVinci Resolve, but there are several advantages to using this standalone app. For example, media does not need to be put in a DaVinci Resolve project first, and you can continue editing while proxies are being generated in the background. Let's check it out. This is the Blackmagic Proxy Generator. It comes bundled in both the free and studio version of DaVinci Resolve. Click Add and navigate to the root folder where all your media is located. Next, choose your proxy format. The different options are ordered according to quality, with the lowest quality but the smallest file size at the top, and the highest quality but the largest file size at the bottom. Consider these scenarios. If you're going to be sharing your proxy files with a remote editor, perhaps use H.264 8-bit. If they have a capable computer, consider using the H.265 option, as it provides 10-bit color with a similar file size to the previous H.264 option. If the proxy files are never going to leave your computer and you have plenty of storage space, you might as well use ProRes 422 10-bit option. Apart from the decrease in resolution, ProRes is capable of storing most of the image quality present in your original camera media. Yes, it's going to produce a larger file size than H.264 and H.265, but the positive side is it's going to take less power to decode. Today, I'm going to create H.264 proxies. Once you've added folders and selected your proxy format, it's time to generate your proxies. Hit Start. To use the proxies in DaVinci Resolve, go to Playback, Proxy Handling, and select Prefer Proxies. When proxies are present, Resolve will use them now. And when they're not, by default, they'll use the original media. You'll notice as the proxy generator works away in the background, the logos of these files change one by one to indicate that proxy media is available for these clips. Proxies are great for editing, as your main priority is smooth playback. When color grading, you might find the lower quality of the proxies makes it harder for you to do certain operations, like creating qualifiers. That's not a problem, just switch back to the original camera media as needed. You'll be pleased to know that when creating your final render, DaVinci always uses the original camera media, unless you specifically configure it to render using the proxies. Proxies are stored alongside the original media in a folder called Proxy. If you want to gather them all into a single folder, perhaps for housekeeping or maybe to send to a remote editor, hit Extract Proxies and choose where you'd like them to be gathered. When you're done with the project, feel free to delete the proxies you've generated. My original media for the project was around 1.5 terabytes. The proxies are only 6.5 gigabytes. What a difference. As you can see, generating proxies is very helpful, whether it is to support your collaborative workflow or just enhance playback at your own workstation. I hope you found this video helpful. Give it a like and subscribe for future tutorials.